This is 9-year-old Bella. She's a girl in a white tuxedo with a top hat. How fun. But she can also be a princess or a pirate.
She's dressed up as a princess, but she also looks at herself as a pirate.
And that's what you wanted to do. That was the goal, right?
Yeah, that was the goal, yeah.
Thanks to Mom, Rachael MacFarlane, and Dad, Spencer Laudiero, author and illustrator of the new children's book, Eleanor Wyatt, Princess and Pirate, the pair is well known for their creative minds. Rachael as Haley Smith on the popular animated sitcom American Dad, and Spencer, a TV animation director. Think Family Guy.
I can be anything that I want to be. I'm a princess, I'm a pirate, but I'm also just me.
This is a beautiful book, just like you. And look at
this, what you
chose to wear. Tell me about this wonderful white tuxedo of yours.
Well, of course, when your mom says wear something nice and you have this and you like to wear it, there's no other choice.
So one day you just sat down and wrote the book.
I did. And I think it came out so quickly because I knew exactly what I wanted to say. It was very specific. It was a message to my daughters and to, you know, kids everywhere that just play in a way that speaks to you. It doesn't have to be gender specific. There aren't any boy toys, there aren't any girl toys, they're just toys. So if you're a boy and you like Barbies or you like dolls, or you're a girl and you like dump trucks and construction, go for it.
And speaking of construction,
this is his man cove, not his man cave.
Spencer invites us into the cove he built. It's a little tight here, but this is where Rachael's words came to life, and Eleanor, Bella, or any other kid can be exactly what they want to be.
She's got other things going on, and not just the princess and the pirate bit. She has girl things, she has boy things, and she's into space, she's into soccer, she's into basketball, music. You know, I just wanted to cover all the bases,
right,
so that there wasn't somebody that felt left out. She has a cowboy hat, she has a black belt for her karate gi.
So talk a little bit about inclusion and why you think it's so important for parents to be teaching their kids at a very early age about inclusion.
Well, it seems like such a basic, simple concept, doesn't it? Something that we are taught from a very early age, that we're all the same underneath, right? It doesn't matter what we look like. It doesn't matter if someone has a disability or they look different from you. We are all the same underneath our exterior. And yet, somehow that message needs to be driven home.
There's a huge part of this that we have a bit of a mental health crisis in this country. And the way to break that down is to stop putting kids in boxes and telling them what they need to be, letting them be who they are.
What are some words or phrases that you use with Bella?
You know, just following your own compass is one that I use a lot. Just you have a true north, and no matter what anybody else says, if you just follow that, you're gonna be okay.
Looks like Bella has taken her parents' advice. By the end of our interview, she decided she'd stay in her tuxedo, but add concert pianist to her repertoire.